Hey guys, welcome back to Maximum Automation and the third part of APM tutorial series. So I hope you have already seen the earlier session for APM tutorial series. So let's just quickly recap that what we have covered so far. These are the list of topics which we have covered in our previous sessions. We have covered APM overview and architecture. We discuss about APM clients. Also, we discussed the high-level overview of different mobile vendor frameworks. We went through the different types of mobile applications. And then we saw what is Android Studio and how to install that. How to create a virtual Android device. How to install APM server. And set up the environment for mobile test automation. So we have covered all these topics in our earlier sessions. If you have missed anything, then you can find the link for these videos in the description, where you can go and watch these videos. Now let's start with today's session. So in this part, we're gonna see how you can run your test on mobile device. Today, we are gonna do the execution on a virtual device created using Android Virtual Device Manager. In our last session, we have seen that how to create a virtual device where you can run your automation test. In case you missed that video, please watch that video to see how to create a virtual device. Now, first, let's go to the Android Device Manager and open the device on which you want to perform your test. So I have created these two devices. One of them runs on Android version 10. And the other one runs on version 11. So I'm gonna use the device with Android version 10. As on this device, I'm facing issues with the Chrome. So to start the device, just click on this run icon. This will start the device in few minutes. So today we're gonna run our automation test on a mobile browser, which means that we're gonna do the test automation for a mobile web application. As we know that we can have three kinds of mobile applications, which we can automate. So today we're gonna start with the mobile web application. These apps are basically the web applications which we access through desktop browsers, but they can be accessed using mobile browsers as well. Like we have Chrome browser in Android and Safari in iOS. So we can use these browsers to open the web application on mobile itself. And then we can write our automation script to test these web applications on mobile devices. As we are going to run the test on an Android device, so we'll be using the Chrome browser to test the application. So the device is up and running. Now let's open the project so that we can add the code to run our automation scripts on mobile. Today, I'm gonna run my test using the C# framework. In next session, I'll cover how to run it using Java framework. Though there is as such no difference apart from the syntax, if you know the syntax or library need to be used for Java or for C#, then you can run your test from any framework. So we'll see in the next session that how to do it using Java. Now let's come back to this framework. And before I start writing the code, the very first thing which we need to do is to add the package for APM client. APM clients are basically a set of libraries which provides all the commands to control the mobile devices. For example, to initiate the connection with APM server, we need to initialize our web driver object with Android driver class. And that class for Android driver will be provided by the APM clients. APM provides the client libraries for each language. So based on your framework or language which you are using, you can get the APM client library. Today we're gonna use our framework using C#. So we'll download the NuGet package for APM client. And to do that, let's go to the NuGet manager and then search apm.webdriver. So in C#, APM webdriver needs to be installed to use APM client libraries. Then click on install to get the latest version for APM driver. So the package gets installed. Now let's go to our feature file. So this is the feature file which we have used to run our test on Amazon using desktop browser. And today I'm gonna run the same test on mobile browser. So I'll just quickly copy the scenario and we'll create a new feature file for mobile test. I'm gonna name it as mobile.feature. So let's paste the scenario over here. Okay, so in this scenario, we're gonna search for a book on Amazon and then we'll select the product from the list of search results. And then we'll verify the price of the book at product detail page. Okay. Now the first thing which we need to do is to get the object identification for mobile web application. There might be some cases where most of the object's properties are same for both desktop and mobile web application. So it totally depends on the implementation of application. Now, to inspect the properties, what we will do is we'll first open the Chrome on mobile device and then navigate to the application for which you want to inspect the objects. So I'm typing amazon.com and then press enter. Now, let's open the Chrome browser on your desktop as well. And then type Chrome:// inspect. Chrome provides the facility for live remote debugging on an Android device from your machine. Make sure that the Discover USB device checkbox is enabled. Connect your Android device directly to your machine using a USB cable. Or if you're using Android virtual device, then please make sure that you have started your device. Here under the remote target, it will display all the connected instances of Chrome browser on remote devices. We can see that our virtual device is getting displayed here. You will see your Android device model name followed by its serial number. Here you can see that it shows that one Chrome instance is open on the remote device. In the Open tab with URL text box, enter a URL and then click Open. The page opens in a new tab on your Android device. To identify the elements, click on Inspect link. A new DevTool instance will get open. The version of Chrome running on your Android device determines the version of DevTools that opens on your development machine. So if your Android device is running a very old version of Chrome, the DevTools instance may look very different than what you are used to. Apart from Inspect, you can see other menus as well to pause, focus, reload, or close a Chrome tab. So now let's click on Inspect to identify the elements. Here you can see that a new DevTools instance opens. And this you can use to identify the elements. Okay, so first element which we want to inspect is the search box. So this is the ID for this element. Let's copy it and paste it on the feature file. And let's go back to the feature file. Paste the ID over here. And you can see that you're getting different ID for this checkbox. And you can see that we are getting different ID for this search box. When we browse it using desktop, we got this ID. And now we are getting the ID value as this when we browsed it using mobile browser. Now let's inspect this search button. Initially, we were using the locator value as input type summit. As you can see here, it remains same when we browsed it on mobile. So we don't need to change this locator value. Now let's type the text which we want to search and hit search button. Similarly, inspect the elements which you are using in your test. Once you are done with all the elements, then we are almost ready to run our first test on mobile device. Now let's go back to the project and move to the step definition class. So here you can see that we have initiated the WebDriver object based on the different desktop browsers. Now we need to add one more condition to initialize the WebDriver object with the Android driver when user wants to run the test on Android Chrome. So I'm gonna add a new condition that if browser type is Chrome Android, then we'll initialize the WebDriver object with Android driver. To initialize the Android driver, we basically need two things. One is the APM server URL where APM is running. And the second one is the APM options object. APM option will contain all the desired capabilities like device name and platform name. So there is a number of desired capabilities which we can use to run our test on the desired application. So let's first create APM option object using new APM options. And then I'll add the desired capabilities using the method called addAdditionalCapability, which basically takes the argument as capability name and the value of the capability. So first capability I'm gonna pass is the device name and then type the value of device name. In current case, it's Pixel 5 API 29. And then I'll provide the another capability for platform name and then type the value as Android. Then the next capability is platform version. As I'm using the Android 10 device, so let's type the value as 10. So these are the basic capabilities which we need to provide so that APM can connect with the desired mobile device. Now, since I'm gonna execute my test on Chrome browser, so I need to provide one more capability to run the test on Chrome browser. And the name of the capability is browser name. And the value will be the Chrome. It should be an empty string if you are automating an app instead of a web application. After that, I'll add one more capability for command timeout. This tells that how long APM will wait for a new command from the client before assuming the client quit and ending the session. To get the list of all desired capabilities, their description, and the values which needs to be provided against these capabilities, you can go to the APM desired capability page by using this URL. Now let's go back to the code as I've added all the required capabilities to run my test. Now we need to initialize the web driver with Android driver. So let's type WebDriver equals to new Android driver of type iWebElement. Here you can use the iMobile element, Android element, or iOS element as well instead of iWebElement. iWebElement is a general interface that all the other classes, iMobile element, Android element, or iOS element implements, which means that if you create an object of type iWebElement, it will have all the basic functions of a web element can have. In case you need specific functions which you can use for only Android or iOS, then you can use other objects like iMobileElement, AndroidElement, or iOSElement. Basically, when you use iWebElement, it will allow you to use all the Selenium commands. While iMobileElement is an APM's element which implements iWebElement and adds APM specific features like touch gestures. AndroidElement and iOSElement implements iMobileElement and add operating system specific features. So based on your requirement, you can use any of the type and then pass the APM URL in the first argument. You need to pass the URL in this format as mentioned in the description. So let's provide the APM server URL over here. And then pass the APM option in the second argument. So we are done with all the changes required to run our test on mobile device. Let's go to the config file and change the browser type value to Chrome-Android so that our test will run on a mobile browser. Currently, we have added our device configuration on the class file itself. So let's create the variable here for all device related configuration so that we can update these configuration at any time. First, I'll add the APM server URL. Provide the server URL over here. Then the device name. And the value will be Pixel 5 API 29. Then platform name, which will be Android. And platform version, which is 10 in our case. And then we'll go to our config setting class file under variable folder. Let's add the properties for all the variables which we have added in our configuration file. So I'm going to create the property for device name, platform name, platform version, and APM URL. So you can add as many variables in your configuration file and then add the properties for those variables in this class so that you can use the values of those variables in your framework. Now let's go back to the step definition file and then replace all these static values with config file variable. So replace this with hooks.config.device name and this one with hooks.config.platform name. This one with hooks.config.platform version and this one with APM URL. Okay, so now we are ready to run our test. So let's hit on run button to execute the test. Let me bring the device to the front so that we can see the execution on the mobile device. Here you can see that execution has been started and that Chrome browser has been invoked on this mobile device. And it started executing our test. So this is how you can run your test on a mobile web browser. In our next video, we'll see how to run your automation test on a real device. Also, we'll see that how to run the test using the Java framework. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to the channel. Also, Please don't forget to click on the bell icon. Thank you.